I know that this is totally impossible, but I would give anything if I could turn the clock back. And continue on from the residential school system interrupted a way of life. I would give anything to get that back.
I had a dream that we flew on golden wings, and we were the same, just the same. Child of the west wind, follow the voice that's calling you home. Follow your dreams, but always
this is my home. This is Niguan's Bay in the Lac Seul First Nation Traditional Territory. And this is where I grew up as a little boy from about 1955 to 1963. And in 1963, I was uprooted from here to attend Pelican Residential School in Seul Lookout. You know, after being assigned a number and being processed, I really didn't understand why I was here. I really didn't know. One of the first things they did was they made us take our clothes off, clothes from home. We were issued new clothes, new pants, new underwear, socks, shoes. And so when you think of that regimented lifestyle compared to the lifestyle that we left, in my case, the trap line and living in Lac Seul First Nation territory, the life of a loving family, to a life of rule and doing things in a way were really foreign. I was abused by an older student, a senior boy when I was a junior boy. I remember this older boy threatening me. That he would beat me up if I didn't do what he wanted me to do. And every once in a while, you could see this particular man lying in bed with a boy. And that happened time and time again. He just were in bed there thinking, I hope he doesn't pick on me tonight. We couldn't tell anybody. We couldn't tell his colleagues or his supervisors. And again, you just picture these young, innocent children shutting down.
This is where I'm from, this is where it started. This is what becomes of the brokenhearted. This is going out to those departed from a life so young it was barely started. And this is going out to the mama's crying because the son's gone home.
After I left here and, you know, started going to high school, those were confusing years. What I would say, the lost years, where I was confused. I really had an identity crisis. You know, am I Anishinaabe? I'm thinking white, but I'm not white. My body is still brown.
Time of grieving as I walk this land of broken dreams. I see the fate of doping fiends. It started out as smoking greens, trying to be like dudes in magazines. Manifested, then infected in our hearts and brains undetected. Felt neglected, but still injected through our veins till the pain was rejected. What we expected, I don't know. Was it
ready? I have to honestly tell you the way it was. It was that I drove Margaret and my kids in what I call a living hell for them. It was not good. Very tough times, dark hours. One of the things about the residential school system was that it made me a very angry person. It made me angry at myself. It made me angry at my parents for allowing me to go to school, and definitely made me angry at the state for even thinking about having a policy where they would attack children. And of course, the churches being spiritually confused, I was completely angered by that. You know, when you've seen and experienced some of the physical and sexual and cultural abuses in residential school, that sticks with you. That is, I think, what we would call learned behavior. And so, you know, sadly, some of those traits, some of those things that we learned in the residential school carry on in our families and in our communities. And that's where a lot of, for example, lateral violence, gossiping, even sexual abuse still carries on in our communities. And that is learned behavior that can be unlearned. And I think that's what we see today.
Watch your back or get black and blue from the poison blue or the poison black. Straight from the hood where they poison rats. Out the windows, hear the noise and gas from youngsters outside that are poised to scrap. Dying over colors, what's the point in that? Killing other brothers, you can't bring them back. Hate it if you like, but I spit the facts. And out here, they be saying they can get with that. So don't get it twisted, just get lifted from the words that I speak, cause it's time to listen. Break the submission, take out the system, raise up the stakes and gain up your wisdom, cause it's right to term. Ain't no life in prison, only killing of the spirit.
They're directly linked to residential school experience. Let me give you an example. You know, when you're institutionalized at a very early age, one doesn't really learn how to parent. One doesn't grow up in a normal, loving, nurturing family. And when you don't have that, that's taken away from you. And that has its effects later on in life when you yourself become a father or a mother. And how do you pass on that love and that nurturing onto your kids when you didn't have that? headline something in regards to prominent Native leader discloses abuse in residential school. I read the paper, read the story. And all of a sudden I'm feeling that little boy who used to go to school on these grounds and what happened. The physical and the sexual abuse that happened. And I began to sob uncontrollably. And I looked at my friend him if he had read the article that I had just finished reading. He said, yes, he acknowledged it. And somewhere was in my unhealthy being, I found the strength to say to him, I was abused sexually. And that was the first time that I had ever told anybody in a way that I was of a sound mind. I was sober. I was hungover, but I was sober. I was able to find the strength to say yes, I was abused. It hasn't been easy. I still have that anger. But you know, in many ways, I have learned to control the anger. It's not so much that it controls me, but I know, in fact, that my partner has been very helpful in helping me in that regard. And really, when you look at so beautiful grandchildren now, do you want them to have a bit of that anger as well? And the answer, obviously, is no. What is that?
A sheep.
A sheep.
Good night, dear sheep.
You know what my nickname used to be?
What?
Sheepy. Yeah. Sheepy. Can you believe that?
Sheepy.
No, I don't believe it either.
Sheepy.
Sheepy.
I can say it though.
Say it. A lot of people think that that part of Canadian history is just about Aboriginal people for Aboriginal people. When in fact, it's a shared history. And it's a shared history of all Canadians, because the residential school policy was a policy of the federal government. And so when people say get over it, what I hear from me is the challenge to create more awareness about what happened. Because a lot of the people who say get over it is a lot of those people who say that really don't understand that history of what happened. The challenge is, what kind of society do we want to create for all of Canada? Your children, my children, our grandchildren, and everybody. And so, to me, it's about renewed relations. I think the first thing that people that I would ask to do is to engage somehow in good dialogue. And whether that means going to the local Friendship Center or going to the a First Nations organization, asking questions, do it. And it's a first step to creating that dialogue. And not to be shy, not to be afraid, because I think when you create that dialogue, it's healthy. It's healthy for those people you're asking, it's healthy for you. And I guess an elder once told me, don't be afraid to talk, because through communication there's a lot of healing, and that's really what this is about.
It's been a long, long winter. I'm so ready for the spring. Sunshine, I will rise up for this day. Plants, they climb up to the sunshine. I will rise up for this day. Rise and shine. You are the world. You are the sky.
When I look into the eyes of Michaela, when I look into the eyes of Isabella, and Nellie, I have to ask myself, what kind of a legacy, or what kind of a society am I trying to create for you? The damage, the hurt, the pain, the suffering has to stop somewhere. It has to stop.
If I can face the change that's coming, then I might make it through the year. Thank you, friend, for holding my hand when the darkness was too up to the sunshine, I will rise up. up for this day. Plants, they climb up to the sunshine. I will rise up for this day.